Hello everyone, my name is He, it's spelled as H-E, and that's it. Yes, it is my name, it is not my pronoun. People get confused all the time. The other day I was drinking in a pub, this cute bro came up to me, he was like, yo, what's your name? I say, my name is He. He was like, huh? I said, He, H-E, sir. And he said, nice to meet you, Ho. I was like, what? Excuse me? I am not a Ho. You know, that's my cousin. Yeah, she is a Ho. You know? Her mom is a Ho. And her dad is a Ho too, you know? Those Hoes are loyal, though. Yeah. As you can tell from my outfit, that I was made in China. Yes. Look, guys, I'm really sorry for the COVID. Yeah. Yeah, I'm sorry for it, but I didn't do it. I was here the whole time. I know. Oh, thank you. Yeah, last year I was roaming around in the city and this guy just yelled at me. He was like, yo, go back to China. I was like, sir, there's no flight. I left China about 3 years ago because I feel pathetic. Yes, people are really judgmental. If you're like me, over the age of 27, not dating or not married in China, you'll be called leftover ladies. I know it is brutal, but I love leftovers. Come on, who doesn't love Chinese leftovers?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're back.
I know, thank you. We are yummy and cheap. That is my Tinder bio. Chinese leftover, yummy. Just take me home and eat me. I know. Yes. My parents are the one who always push me to get married. I remember my 30th birthday, my dad just told me. He was like, huh. Can you lower your standards and get a husband? I was like, what, Dad? I don't have any standards. You know, just like my mom. Yep, I know. Yeah. I don't understand why people want to get married. Almost all of my married friends are miserable. The other day I was chatting with a friend, she was complaining that I wish I hadn't married, you know? All the BS from my in-laws, my husband is lazy, my kid is a failure. I was like, what the heck, mom? Are you serious, you know? No wonder I'm not married. That's my time, thank you guys so much.
Hello.
How you doing?
What's your name, please?
My name is Preacher Lawson.
I love that. And how old are you?
I'm 25. I'll turn 26 in 2 hours.
He's young enough to be with me.
Are you single, married?
I have a girlfriend.
You have a girlfriend?
She's dope. Yeah.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a stand-up comedian, which means I'm unemployed and I do stand-up on the side.
All right, best of luck.
All right. I got a motorcycle. I don't like telling people I have a motorcycle because every time I tell someone, they always got to tell me a story about how their friends crashed on a motorcycle. You know, like, why do people have to be so negative? I don't go up to pregnant women telling them my dad left. You know what I'm saying? So annoying. So annoying. I walked at my apartment one time, right? I walked at my apartment and my neighbor walked up to me. She was like, oh my God, you got a motorcycle? Are you Cyrus? You better be careful. I got in a car wreck the other day. My car flipped 8 times. I'm lucky to be alive, blessed, right? She black, by the way. Everyone around us was like, you know, that is crazy that your car flipped 8 times, you're alive, you are blessed, you know? And I'm over here thinking, who the heck counted, right? Like, who's that calm when their car's flipping in the air? Ah! One! Like, who's doing that? My name is Preacher, thank you so much, I appreciate it.
That's it.
Preacher, can I have just one more joke?
All right. I don't feel safe driving with my grandma because she's really spiritual. She loved the Lord to the point where she's not afraid of dying. So I don't like that, all right? I don't like being in a car with someone that's not afraid of death, okay? Like, she got that attitude like, if I die, I'm going to heaven, so it don't matter. I'm like, it does matter because I'm in the car, okay? This is how spiritual my grandma is. If I got shot in the chest with a gun 8 times, instead of her calling the ambulance, she would get on her knees praying like, please, Lord Jesus, I get these 8 demons outside my grandbaby's chest. Let the bullets rise up and part ways from his chest like Moses did the Red Sea. Yes, Lord. Let the blessings rain down. Yes, Lord. Lil John 3:16.
Hello. Hi. And what's your name?
Gatis Kandis.
Where are you from?
Latvia.
Okay, from Latvia. Why did you come here?
I came here to live.
Good luck.
Okay. Okay. Hello. Are there any guys with big muscles in the audience? No, good, then I'll talk about them. You know, those big muscles make those guys so heavy that they cannot ride a pony. However, they can break a fragile toilet seat. I mean, do they work out to attract the ladies? Well, actually, the ladies are attracted to what's inside of a man. Back me up, ladies. If you agree, say yeah. Rapidly moving on. Public toilets, can't live without them, can't live in them either. Because there is no fridge and microwave there. Often when I use the male toilet, some guys there fart very loud, and I don't like that. So when possible, I sneak into the ladies' toilets instead, because they're much more discreet about it. Well, at least when they know that I am there. Seeing is believing, and weeing is relieving.
He's the funniest bloke we've had in Hammersmith.
More. Yes. Are you well?
Yeah.
No, you're not a well. You're a person.
What is going on here? You are the funniest, unfunniest comedian I have ever heard in my life. I mean, absolute rubbish, but it actually really, really made me laugh.
That was my aim, to make you laugh.
Well, you certainly did that, Gatiss.
It was so bad that it was actually brilliant.
Yeah. You mustn't change. You seriously must not change.
Not even the jumper. Keep the jumper.
What's wrong with my jumper?
There's nothing wrong with it. It's hilarious.
I'm going to kick this off because you did actually make me laugh, and that's what comedians are supposed to do, so I'm going to say yes.
Thank you so much.
I'm going to say yes. It's a no from me today.
David? So it rests with me. way you must judge comedy is, did it make you laugh? It made me laugh. I'm going to say yes.
Well done, Paul!
Oh, little man!
Is that you, Deck? Please, sir, tell us your name.
I'm Ned.
How old are you, Ned?
I'm 8.
So cute!
Where are you from?
Maidstone.
Oh! Who's here with you today?
Well, I'm with my mum, my dad, my stepmum, my sister, my other sister, and my brother.
Fantastic. Do you perform for friends and family? Do you get up in school and do shows?
Yeah.
The stage is yours, sir. Good luck.
Oh, I love him already.
Come on, Ned.
Why were people so excited about that talking dog on Britain's Got Talent? Amanda Holden's been on it for years. Savage. Anton Deck backstage, but I'm never quite sure which one's supposed to be the funny one.
Oh, he's killing us all!
Alicia?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Alicia laughing?
Oh, no.
Alicia not dancing?
That was good.
Simon.
Godson.
Who reminds me a lot of my dad. He's a cross-dresser. He gets especially cross when he can't find his socks. I was really worried for David Williams when he swam on the River Thames for charity because of all that garbage going in his mouth. But since I've been watching BGT, I'm relieved it's all coming out again.
Very
well done, Ned.
Ned, I loved the way that you took the Mickey out of us. It was really quite savage.
What is your name?
I'm Mikey Winfield.
Mikey, what is your age?
Oh, so I'm like 20s to like 30s and stuff, you know, all right.
Where are you from?
I'm originally from Baltimore. I did adequate time in Sacramento, a lot of love.
What do you do?
You know what? I tell jokes, you know?
How long you been doing this?
Over 15 years.
So do you even remember the first time you step on a stage?
Oh my gosh, do I remember? Yeah, it was a Tuesday night open mic. And I get on stage with bright lights and arms crossed, and now they're all staring at me, and I just kind of freeze. So the fact that I came back, that means there's something wrong with me.
Okay, so show us what is wrong with you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, thank you. I love older moms. Like, I like it when her kids just moved out. I can set up my computer in the extra bedroom, you know? I got married to an older woman. I got a stepson. It's cool being a parent to a kid that's close to your age. I call him Stepman. He drove me here. That's my step homeboy, man. And it's a weird dynamic if you see it. He's like 6'2 with chest hair. I don't have any, you know? Teenage boys can be gross. You know when they're doing inappropriate stuff on their laptop, because when you walk in on them, they'll slam it down really fast and then ask you some irrelevant question. I walk in on Stepman, he's like,
who's running for Congress? I'm like, oh, Stepman. I quit my job at the grocery store. Stepman's like, what are we gonna do for money, Step Mike? I'm like, hey, don't worry about it, okay? And I worked at this grocery store for a lot of hateful years. Why is it when you hate your job, they won't fire you? And now look, I worked in the worst department at the grocery store. Not the meat, not produce, not the freezer. I worked in the steel department. You familiar with the steel department, right? Self-checkout lane? I got paid to watch people steal all day. And people think you stupid. Like, you know when they gonna rob you when they're ringing up their stuff, they always gotta look back up at you. They're like, boop, boop. This one dude tried to humiliate me. Like, I knew he was gonna rob us because I'm looking at him, he's looking at me. I'm like, just steal it. But he tries to play me in front of the entire store while he's ringing his stuff up. He makes the beat noise with his mouth. He didn't even do it right. Like, you gotta act this out, go all in, raise your pitch at least. He's like, bleh. Like, the produce is not even supposed to make a sound. You're beeping unbeepable stuff. Hey, you guys, I'm Mikey Winfield. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.
Look at these people.
Oh, they're hearing it all. Look at this.
Wow. Thank you so much.
I mean, I don't think there's anything else to say. They love you.
Oh,
I
man.
Love you.
Thank you.
It's amazing. Your energy, your smile. I loved it.
Oh, thank you.
Howie.
Everything you say is memorable, is authentic. Your thank smile, you. Your persona. You're great. You're great.
Wow. Wow. I appreciate it.
Heidi.
You are fantastic. And then there's this face.
Thank you.
Look at his face. That face is just so cute.
Why don't you mention his face?
Isn't his face so cute? Yeah.
Stop it.
Well, you have a real star quality about you,
he
Mike.
He does.
You really do.
Yes.
Absolutely.
We could never do this show without an audience, particularly with an act like yourself, and this audience loved you. I mean, you could tell that.
Thank you, Simon. Thank you all. I appreciate you.
And Mike, look, we always say an audition on this show, 2 minutes literally can change your life. Maybe this is one of those auditions. I've got a good feeling about you.
Thank you.
Well, we're going to start voting. Simon.
Yes.
Me, yes.
Yes.
Four yeses.
Thank you.
Wow, thank you. Wow, thank you so much. So good to be back. I know that many of you know who I am. But I'm also well aware that maybe this is your first time seeing me. And if that's the case, then I'm pretty sure you're like, wow, AGT is really scraping the bottom of the barrel here. I travel a lot doing comedy, and everywhere I go, I see more and more handicap accessible stuff going in everywhere, which I think is very important. Yeah. But I have to tell you, as a physically disabled person, I kind of feel obligated to use that stuff. You know how awkward that is when I'm on a date and I gotta use the ramp? I'll be there in a minute, babe. I'll be welcome. Oh, hold on, honey. Let me get the door for you. Okay. Who says chivalry is dead, huh? You know, over the years being disabled, I've experienced some cruelty, and whenever somebody's mean about disability, what I think they don't realize is that the disabled community is the largest minority group on the planet because they pile us all together. So if you're blind, get in the pile. If you're deaf, help the blind guy find the pile. You got one leg? Hop on. All right, I'll stop. All right, that's too far. I understand, too far. But whenever people are being mean about disability, what I think they don't realize is not only are we the largest minority group, but we're also the only minority group that you can join at any time. That's right. You're just one bad bike ride away. Ain't that right, Simon? You guys are awesome. Thank you so much.
Nice to meet you. Hello, everyone. Hi.
Hello.
Sorry, a bit nervous.
Who are you?
I'm Phil W. Green. I'm 21, and I'm going to be doing comedy impressions.
Hooray!
Phil, do you do this full-time?
No, I don't, no.
What do you do?
I work at Body Shop at the moment as a customer consultant.
I bet your dream is to be a big international
yes,
star.
Yes, I'd love to be on stage.
Philip, did you bring anyone with you?
So, my friend Christy.
Did she work at Body Shop?
She did, but she's recently left.
Why?
Because she found a better job.
Found a better job!
Sorry!
Where?
She now works at Barrett's, so... Shoes!
I hope he's good after all of this.
OK, well, look, Philip, you've got roughly 2 minutes. Let's do it.
OK. Hello, I'm Natalie Cassidy. And today, we're going to be health working out. So everyone put your hands out in front of you, spread your legs, and do some squats. Lie down, the baby, on Martin Fowler's sofa. Isn't that right? Don Cotton would be proud, wouldn't she? Ooh, it's so nice to be here on my new show. And today's guest is absolutely fantastic. You know what? I'm going to meet her. Hello. Oh, thanks for having me, Charlotte. Oh, I'm so nervous. Oh, come here. Oh. And then, oh, I was on Guana the Jungle recently. Oh, my God. I mean, I saw those ones, and I was like, whoa. And then I saw even more ones, and I was like, whoa. And then they tried to make me eat the ones, and I was like, whoa. And I was like, whoa. And then I was being sick everywhere.
Oh, my goodness. Have you seen the bacteria in here? It is awful. Isn't that right, Kim?
Oh, my love. Oh, that stinks. Dance. It's me, Louis Spence, dancing. Everyone up the top. Come on, duck. Everyone, come on, duck. Everyone, duck. Duck. And down. Duck. And down. And Spence. Duck. Oh. Ooh.
The brilliant thing about your act was that you had us laughing before you even did anything.
Oh, thanks, Amanda.
David!
You're like a butch version of me. You're a very, very funny guy. I'd like to see some more of you in the act as well. Because you are hysterically funny as you as well.
Are you sure you're not related to Stacey Solomon?
I wish I was. I've seen her from a distance and I was like, Stacey. But no.
I think you're really funny, lovable. Do you need a wee?
No. I'm just really nervous. Sorry.
Simon?
It was like the world record for how many impersonations you can do in 2 minutes. I found it difficult to keep up with some of them. The ones that were great.
Oh, thanks.
But you are a naturally funny guy.
Oh, thanks.
Slightly bonkers. But I like that.
We're gonna take a vote. David, yes or no?
I'm gonna say yes.
It's a yes from me.
And we have actually had some good impressionists on the show this year. So you have got some competition. But I am going to say... yes.
That's four yeses. You're through for the next round.
Thank you so much. It's nice to meet you all. See you soon. Bye-bye.
Hello, my name is Lee, and for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dec.
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But, just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs. Special schools, Special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Tell us your name.
I'm Jackie Fabulous.
And where are you from, Jackie?
I'm from the Bronx. I'm from Bronx, New York.
Boogie down.
Oh yeah!
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a full-time touring stand-up comic, yes.
Oh, wow.
So what got you into comedy?
You know, I went to law school. I'm a lawyer. I know, right? Total disappointment. I had to quit my lawyer job because I got fired. So it made it awkward being there every day, you know what I mean?
So when you got fired, were your parents supportive?
No.
Oh, no.
They don't understand what I'm doing. They don't get it. They don't understand who leaves being a lawyer to be a stand-up comic. They're like, why are you doing this to your life?
I don't want to wait any longer. Take it away, Jackie.
All righty. My Jamaican mother wants me to lose weight, but she doesn't know how to tell me. She's in New York, she comes to LA. You know how you see your parents, you become a child again? I'm like, oh my God, mommy! She's like, Jacqueline, Lord have mercy, you're fat. Jesus, you are fat. What are you eating, people? I don't like weight loss TV shows. If you love that show, The Biggest Loser, you and I can't be friends. You know how that show works? If somebody's overweight, you lock them on an island, and they have to work out 8 hours a day, 7 days a week, and oh yeah, we're gonna make you wear a small spandex bra and baby panties and weigh you on a scale meant for cattle on national TV. Wouldn't you lose weight? Who's losing these contests? You want to impress me, get a bunch of fatties and lock them in a donut shop. The first one to not go into a diabetic coma wins. That's the show I would support.
She's getting them. She's winning them over.
I don't like Facebook. It's too much work for me now. It's cool till you find that friend from too far back. You know how they find you? And they're like, oh my God, I found you. What have you been doing? I'm like, last time I saw you, I learned how to read, learned how to write. Puberty was wrong. Who's this? And they send you news you don't need. Did you hear Sister Mary Ellen passed away? I'm like, when you and I were 8, she was 88. She a wizard? Is she a warlock? I hope she's dead. Should have been dead 30 years ago. And all done. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, guys.
You killed it.
Thank you.
Hello, hi, everyone. Hello, Simon, Amanda, Alicia. Thank you. I have to say, I'm slightly nervous today because as I was setting up the keyboard, I noticed that David's got the same tie as my ex-boyfriend, and David was actually the name of my ex-boyfriend's ever. No, not my ex-boyfriend, my next. Thank you. Just trying to connect, you know. Thank you. Gay dating is very tricky, you will find out later. Particularly for me, because as I said last time, I've got something called Asperger's syndrome, although I am aware that if you mention autism on stage, sometimes audiences can sort of like go awkward and silent. Like that. I remember I was bullied at school. I remember I went on a farm trip and this kid actually got me to kiss a sheep. Yes. How did they pull the wool over my eyes? Anyway, I had to leave that school and take up a different teaching position. So, coming out was tricky. I told my granddad I was gay and he went, oh, where in nature do two men fall in love? I said, clap and comment. Although my nan was nice, I told her and she said, whatever I do in my own bed is my own business, which was lovely, and until I told her I'd done it in her bed. No, it's okay, she was asleep. I'm joking, she was awake. And then last time I basically did a song about nothing. Now I've got a song about something that's about sort of fitting in and being different and stuff. And it's a song about the panel, so ooh-ah. And also, they made me change it 3 days ago, so it's confused me, but I understand why. But I am up to challenges. When I was 16, I was 16 stone. So as I said then, you know, life's like a box of chocolates. Yes, empty. So, so here we go. I don't need no carer to take me to the loos. Although if you try to wipe my bottom, I'll never refuse. I'm only socially awkward and slightly obsessed. So if you say bad things, I'm not impressed. There's lots of people in the world who are one way obsessed. Elton John is obsessed with his homosexual spending. David Walliams is obsessed with his heterosexual pretending. I'm not sure how you behave. Go on, David, give me a wave. Before you waved, it was a maybe, but with that hand action, you actually outgave me. Donald Trump is obsessed with his ridiculous hairdo. Amanda Holden is obsessed at trying to look young. No. Like she used to. Anyway, it's not the truth, it's just in that chair as I find you. That chair is sort of reflecting your younger years. It's behind you. Gordon Ramsay is obsessed with swearing at his cooker. Alicia Dixon is obsessed by dressing like a cooker. No. Simon Cowell's judging is so obsessive because out of all of the lovely Britons got talent choice, the one thing he likes the most is the sound of his own voice. Thank you. Although I think your voice is lovely, so it's a shame we won't form a romantic hook. Instead, I'm going to have to remember your face for later with this look.
Obviously, I'm from Brixton. No, I'm joking. I'm from America, y'all. What's up? Yeah, apparently Englanders think we're dumb. And you're right, we're dumb. But we got dentists, okay? You can't have everything, all right? I'm feeling good, man. I'm feeling good from this jet lag. I drank some coffee. I normally don't drink coffee. So when I did, I was surprised. And I felt so energetic. I was like, man, I feel so energetic. I feel so energized and alert. Why don't I drink more coffee? And then my booty was like, this is why, and snuck up on me. I was not ready. You ever accidentally start the salsa to the bathroom? You're like, where did I learn this? It was bad. You ever go to the bathroom thinking you only gotta pee, and then when you get there, your body's like, nah, son, we got work to do. I destroyed that bathroom. I couldn't breathe for 11 seconds. I lost brain cells. I was like, why is my arm in the toilet? It was so big, but I'm good. Some of y'all had that experience, all right? So, I was on a show called America's Got Talent. That's why I know you, Simon. Yeah, I was on America's Got Talent. And who's seen that? Who's seen America's Got Talent? Who's seen me on America's? Have you seen me? You seen me? Okay. Who voted for me, though? Of course you didn't, London. I lost to a 12-year-old ventriloquist. She didn't open her mouth the whole time. You never know what it feels like losing $1 million to somebody that still has chores. You'll never know. People ask me all the time, they're like, you still talk to Darcy? I'm like, she's 14, bruh. No. I'm a grown man. What am I gonna do? Hey, Darcy, how was school? Like, no, man. Plus, she beat me, so I hate her. Why would I talk to someone I hate? Don't hate Darcy. She's an angel. So is the devil, okay? Now, I'm not. She's not the devil. I love her and her family. The greats. I don't feel like I lost on this show for a couple reasons. First reason I don't feel like I lost on the show is because I was homeless 3.5 years ago. I'm far from that now, right? I'll never be homeless again in my life. Thank you. That's right. That's right. I got money now. I got way more friends and family members than I remember on the show. I don't know if y'all know who Tyra Banks is, but she's pretty much, yeah, y'all know who Tyra Banks is. If you don't know, welcome to Earth. And she's pretty much the American version of Ant and Dec. You know, they're both like hosts on major shows and they're both supermodels. So they're the same people. And on the show, she licked my face, okay? I could die tonight. You don't understand. She licked my face, y'all. I licked her hand first, though. I licked her hand first, all right? What happened was she was interviewing me, and I was like, I can't believe I'm talking to you, Tyra Banks. And she was like, yeah, it's me. And she put her hand out. And she was like, you can pinch my hand and see if I'm real. Matter of fact, you can kiss it. And I was like, kiss it? Because I don't know when I'm going to get this opportunity again. So I licked her. She started laughing. I was like, thank you, Jesus. I'm not going to jail. I went on stage, right? She was interviewing me, right? She was like, you ready to do this? I was like, I'm ready. She was like, go get him, Tiger. I laughed. I was like, funny you call me a tiger, because I'm feeling great, like the cereal in America. Don't worry about it. Anyway, so I went on stage. And you know how the judges on these shows, they always ask you all these random questions, like, hey, preacher, what's your favorite color? You got a favorite color? Huh? You got a girlfriend? What girlfriend? And at the time, I had a girlfriend. So I was like, yeah, I got a girl. She dope. I do my performance. I get off stage. Tyra Banks is waiting for me. Everybody happy but Tyra, all right? I walk off, and she's mad. She was like, why would you let me lick your face on national television, preacher? You got a girlfriend. And I replied, I'll let you lick my face, Tyra, because you're Tyra Banks, okay? Why would I not let Tyra Banks lick my face? If my girl had a chance for Aunt and Dec to lick her face and she turned it down, I'm dumping her, because I don't want to date anybody that stupid. Are you serious? If I had a chance for Aunt and Dec to lick my face, I am dressing up like an ice cream cone. You don't understand. They about to get all this. My name is Preacher Lawson. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. I love you. Thank you. Thank you.
How are you?
I'm very well. I'm fine. I mean, how can I not be fine? I'm in the America's Got Talent. Oh my God!
What is your name?
My name is Josh Alfred.
Where are you from?
I'm from Nigeria.
Woo! How old are you?
I'm 32 years old.
And what is your talent, Josh?
Okay, I do something very different, something you've never seen. I'm a speed reader.
Oh.
A speed reader.
Yeah.
That is something very different.
Yeah. In a twinkle of an eye, I can read so many pages.
Do you think you can win $1 million?
When I was leaving Nigeria, I told them that I was not going to leave the United States if I don't win.
What would you do with $1 million?
I will buy books.
$1 million worth of books?
Yeah.
Okay, Josh, good luck tonight. We're so happy that you made it all the way from Nigeria.
Thank you. Why is reading a talent?
I don't know.
So I'm going to be reading 3 books within a minute. I'll finish it up. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Kill the You want me to explain? You can ask me questions about the book.
No, you want to ask him any question.
What's the ending of Romeo and Juliet?
I guess they died or something. I don't know.
Simon, what did you think?
Pointless.
But I read those books. I mean, I have witnesses.
I want to know, how is this an act? Like, okay, you read this, and now what?
And it's been read.
I think we need to stop this thing. I'm going to give you a no, first no.
Howie.
Yes, no, what?
Read my lips. No.
Heidi.
It's a no.
Simon.
No.
I think you're making a mistake.
We are okay making a mistake. Thank you very much.
I won't take a no, though.
Aww.
I won't take it.
What the heck is it?
That was the most ridiculous
thing
I ever saw.
Josh, come here, man. First of all, they can't prove you didn't read those books.
They didn't read it.
You see what I mean? They don't understand genius.
I think they made a mistake. I just keep coming back till they realize.
All right, thank you so much.
Good evening.
We know him.
What is your name?
My name is Josh. I'm from Nigeria.
Nigeria.
He snuck back in.
All right.
What do you do?
I'm the fastest rapper in the world.
All right, well, good luck. I hope this works out.
Yeah.
Check it. Hesses me, effy is with the with the when they just move like we should win this with the pick it with the bus of over the window, some of the widget bus with the fellow. What's that? I said, all I know. Ever since my first pick it, the honey.
Was that the whole thing?
I was getting to the best part. I was about to kill it.
Why didn't you keep going?
Keep it going. Go, JS, go.
Were you finished?
I was about to hit
get to the best parts. Simon, what do you think?
Well, I didn't really understand any of it, if I'm being honest with you.
It was because it was fast.
You were not saying anything.
But I believe that people that understand fast rap, they will slow it down in their minds and they will get it.
Maybe you need to work on your singing and come back to AGT another time. But it's gonna have to be a no for me.
It's a no, I'm sorry.
No.
I'm afraid it's a no, sorry.
I think that's a mistake, so you guys are making a mistake.
Actually, no, I've changed my mind this year. No, I'm kidding. It's a... No.
Why didn't he
come back?
What do? You just get back in line and you try again?
I don't know what happened.
I mean, really? He came back in again.
No way. No way.
He's back.
What is your name?
My name is Terrifying Jay.
No! It's the same guy. He keeps coming back.
Wait a minute.
And what do you do?
I do magic.
All right, you know what? Just show us your magic, young man.
Okay, so first of all, we have to agree that all the cards here are different.
Yes.
They're different.
We have 10 of hearts, we have clubs, we have spades, we have diamond.
Let him do his act.
Howie.
What?
I want to connect some part of your life to this card.
Okay.
What's your birth month?
November.
That should be 11, right? How would you feel if I pick your exact birth month?
How do you pick an 11? Well, that would be amazing.
Good.
That would be really amazing.
Ay, Dios mío.
All right, just say stop where you want me to stop, please.
I wanted you to stop before I pressed the X.
All right, let's go. Let's do this.
I didn't say stop. What is that?
That's 10.
Yes.
10 plus 1
is 11.
That's it. Okay. I want to call. Terry, please come. Come, Terry. I'm going to control Terry's mind. Terry, did we talk backstage? Did we rehearse this?
No, we didn't.
All right, I'm going to control you now.
Okay.
Terry, please raise your hand. Raise this hand up. Can you please wave? Can you please smile? Can you please frown? I control his mind. Thank you, Terry. God bless you. Thank you.
All right. Sophia, what did you think?
You're funny, but it's like really not for AGT. So again, no.
You're very likable, but you just didn't get it.
Seriously, I've now got it. I think you are hilarious. I really, really like you. You're really funny. So I'll make this really quick. You got four yeses. Well done.
No! Yes.
Honestly, you're funny now, but it's a no. I am sorry.
I can rap. I can do the rap.
No, you don't need to rap. You don't need to rap.
It's the best of perfect, it's been a fit of the song. And it missed the rest of it, it's the best of the fall. And it's just perfect, it's straight up, it's the way the rock. And it's
fit,
and it's
fit,
it's so perfect.
It's over, it's over.
It's the perfect, open the window, and the whistle, and the whistle.
It's enough for me.
Do you have a second song?
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
Tell us your name and where you're from.
私の名前は市川小井口です。日本から来ました。
Why are you yelling?
元気が有り余ってるからです。
So how do you prepare for your performance?
このパフォーマンスのために3日間食事をとってません。だからお腹がすごく空いています。早くパフォーマンスをさせてください。
So you can start now. Good luck.
Thank you. First this.Okay, music, start! Hey, hey, hey! Yeah! Wow! Next is this! Hey! Hey! I'd like to change your life. Okay. Let's start.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I'm
So, why did you have to fast for 3 days?
胃の中に空気を入れてるんです。胃が空っぽの方がたくさんの空気が入って、技のパフォーマンスの質が上がります。
Let's just vote. It's a yes from
no,
me.
No, it's not. You're out of your mind. No.
I can't say no to him. He's so inspirational. David.
Yes.
Stop yelling.
Hi.
Yeah. All right, for me, it's a yes.
Yes! Yes!
We have one more vote.
Oh. Yes! 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 Yes!
Okay, I can't do it either, so it's a yes.
Yes!
Hi, my name is Nabil Abdul Rashid, and I'm from Croydon, South London.
How old are you?
I'm 34.
34. Why are you here today?
I've spent so much time doing other stuff, but now I want to pursue this. It's going to give me a chance to chase my dream and spend more time with my kids.
But you've been harboring a dream, have you, for the whole
yes.
of your life?
Oh, yes. Or a nightmare, depending on how you look at it. I mean...
Well, look, we don't know what you're going to do. We like to be surprised. So, Nabil, take it away.
So, Sky and all people, you all right? In case you haven't figured it out, yes, I am a stand-up comic. My name is Nabil Abdul Rashid, and I am a Muslim, which is something... I'm not gonna lie, that's not the reaction I was expecting. I have to announce that I'm Muslim because people never seem to realize I am until it's too late. Recently, like, it was my birthday, right? Some of my colleagues found out it was my birthday. One of them was like, yo, fam! It's your birthday, can't say nothing, fam. Say nothing, fam. Man's got you, fam. Man's got a surprise for you, rude man. I said, why are you talking like that? You're Irish. And he said, took me out. Where did he take me? A bar for a cocktail party. I'm like, bruv, you know I don't drink. He said, yeah. I know you do the Muslim thing, but it's your birthday, rude boy. Loosen up. It's my birthday, so what next? Hey, Nabil, I know you have a nut allergy, but you see this peanut butter sandwich, fam? It's banging. Loosen up.
It's good, man.
Because people tell me I don't look like a Nabil Abdul Rashid. Apparently, I look more like a Tyrone. Or a Marlon, or maybe even a Babatunde, you know, whatever. I turned up to a show recently. They wouldn't let me in. I turned up to the group like, excuse me, you can't be here. This green room is for a Nabil Abdul Shekhabal. I'm like, no, it's Abdul Rashid. Yes, that's what I said, Abdul Shish Kebab. My mother said, I don't mean to offend you, but has anyone ever told you that your name sounds a bit Muslim? I said, yes, that's because I am a Muslim. He said, okay, well, at least tell me what the name means. I said, the name Nabil Abdul Rashid basically means that my phone calls are monitored. Now, the annoying thing about being Muslim in 21st century Britain is you know the MI5 prevent and Home Office listening on your phone calls, but they don't go halves on Nabil. They follow you on Twitter, they don't retweet. They follow you on Facebook, but they don't poke. Well, not on Facebook. They poke you at the airport. I mean. That's my time, man. But...
Thank you.
cold. Yeah, it just felt right. Congratulations.
Well done. Woo!
I didn't do that. You did that. Trust me. You're edgy. You're charismatic. And I just loved it. I absolutely loved it. It was fantastic.
The writing is perfect. The delivery is perfect. I want to say thank you for coming on this show and bringing this style of humour, because it makes the show grow.
I didn't think I was going to do that today, but it just felt right. You are a breath of fresh air.
Give your
What is your name?
My name is Aiko, and I am from Japan. I live here now, and daytime I'm a translator, and I love my job because when I screw up, I'm the only person who knows about it.
Yeah.
So today you're coming to AGT to
yes.
do what?
I'm here to do a stand-up comedy.
You want to start already?
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Okay. My name is Aiko. In Japanese, it means love child. So I look up the dictionary. It says illegitimate child. My last name is Tanaka. It means in the rice field. So my whole name is illegitimate child in a rice field. Oh. Nice to meet you. I love rice.
Me too.
Is this a rice crowd? Yeah. I just got the citizenship.
Yeah!
Until I got my citizenship, I never had a road rage. If somebody cut me off, I'd be like, oh, so sorry. I was driving too slow. But the day I got the citizenship, somebody cut me off. I'm like, what the heck? You can't cut me off. This is my land. That's when I realized I become true American.
Oh, that's great. He's hilarious.
Because I felt entitled.
Oh!
Before the citizenship, somebody hold the door for me. I ran really fast. I'm like, thank you so much. After the citizenship, I'm like, you hold the door, you peasant. I got sassy.
I love her.
Racist people always say immigrants should not be working. I agree. We work too much.
That's a good point.
Now, whenever I feel lazy and I take a nap, I'm like, I'm doing this for America. Thank you. That's my time.
I mean, I was really enjoying it, and I think all of us were enjoying
Everybody
it.
Everybody was.
Thank you. Good job!
Why are you so emotional?
I struggle with insecurity. Or a lot of people say I cannot do it because this is not my language. But then I had one person who really believed in me, which is my mom.
Your mom?
Uh, last year during the pandemic, she passed away. Aww. She wanted me to go for my dream.
I love it.
How long have you been doing this?
For a few years. I perform everywhere. I perform in the prison. It's...
Well, it's important to have a captive audience, and
yes,
you
yeah,
found
yeah,
one.
Yeah.
I think your career is about to skyrocket, young lady. Mama was right.
Heidi!
From jail to America's Got Talent. I also thought you were hilarious.
Thank you.
But since you have your citizenship, don't get into trouble.
No, get into trouble. That's going to be your bread and butter, I'm telling you.
But I had a lot of fun.
Simon, what did you think?
I mean, so funny, so naughty. From the minute you walked out, you got us, you know? And the best sign of a comedian's doing well, obviously, is the audience. And I really liked your reaction afterwards, because I could see how much this reaction meant to you as well. So I would like to give you your first yes. You look happy.
I am. I'm quite delighted. Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Daliso. Daliso Chaponda.
That's an amazing name.
That's a Malawian name.
Malawian.
Yes. So I'm from Malawi, but I live in Manchester.
Why have you come on Britain's Got Talent?
I've come to make the people laugh. I am a comedian.
Oh,
and
yes!
I'm a comedy writer.
I would love the winner of Britain's Got Talent this year to be a comedian.
Oh, no pressure.
No pressure.
Who are you here with?
So I'm here just alone. My brother, he wanted to come, he's a doctor, and he was like, either I should save lives or come with you.
Were your parents disappointed that one of you was a comedian, one of you was a doctor?
They were absolutely horrified because I was studying computer programming, so I had a future. And I just decided, no, let me be a clown. So we shall see.
Oh, darling, good luck.
Okay, excellent. Well, I'm at that age now, all my friends are getting married, and married people forget how horrible it is being single. They love to call me and complain about their coupley problems. Always get, you are so lucky being single. I get home, my wife just starts nagging, nag, nag, nag. I'm like, hey, I have to nag myself. I get home, I'm like, what time do I call this? Why don't I ever do the dishes? Sometimes I think I don't appreciate myself. I haven't always been a comedian. I did some weird jobs. I used to clean houses, and I'll admit I was tempted to steal. I didn't steal because the Bible says, thou shalt not steal, but nowhere does it say, thou shalt not swap. I took a stereo, left a Walkman. Took a plasma screen, left an Etch-a-Sketch. As I mentioned, I am from Africa. I moved here 10 years ago, and immediately I moved here, I heard a lot of British people talking about the financial crisis, the recession. I'm from Africa, what are you maniacs talking about? You call that a crisis? If that's a crisis, where is UNICEF? Where is Bono? I have not seen one Save the UK concert. You can tell me it's a financial crisis when there are planes flying over Birmingham tossing fish and chips out the window. It will be a financial crisis when there are ads on television saying this Chav has to walk 5 miles a day to get a bottle of WKD Blue. And 100%, you have got a financial crisis when India starts opening call centers here. Can you imagine some poor guy in Mumbai calls his bank, ends up talking to a Brummie? Thank you so much, Brummie.
I mean, laugh after laugh after laugh. It just kept on coming. And I really want you to win the entire series!
Thank you.
I think you could. And I think you have a golden future.
Oh, thank you so much. I'm shocked and delighted.
So am I. Wonderful. I mean, my face is hurting from laughing. I'm so pleased that Amanda pressed a golden buzzer for you. You are brilliant, and I cannot wait to hear more from you. Well
done. Thank you so much. Thank you very much.
You should be a comedy superstar.
Yes.
All the jokes were really original, and you are incredibly likable. I couldn't fault it. Well done.
Thank you very much.
Well, not only do I think you're an undiscovered little star, I could see you owning your own show.
Thank you.
What you did was so funny and naughty and unique. This is why we make shows like this, to find people like you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Todju.
And how old are you?
40.
And are you married?
Is that a proposal? No, not married. Not to my knowledge.
And what is it that you're doing for us today?
Stand-up, impressions.
Brilliant.
We'll wish you all the best.
Yes.
Thank you. I love TV, man. Anybody here remember Blind Date?
Ladies and gentlemen,
it's Blind Date!
And here's your host,
Missilla Black!
Oh. We've got three bunny lads behind that screen.
I didn't expect them to do Scylla. I really didn't.
And here's the gorgeous girl who's got a meeting. Her name's Amanda. Come in, Amanda.
You know, I'd love to have seen. The screen goes back. She doesn't like the look of the guy. She makes it clear. Do 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 do. Pretty women, why do you always come to the club with a friend that doesn't look as cute as you? Yes, and guys, just as you're about to get the cute one's number, the friend comes along and messes it up completely. Yes, let me set the scene, Alicia. Hi, you're kind of cute. Oh, you're cute too. Here comes the friend. Then they turn to their friend. Who is he? Who is he? Who is he? Then they turn back to you. Are you a nutter? You look like a nutter. You act like a nutter. Can you prove you're not a nutter? Exactly what I thought. You are a nutter. If I'm not getting a man, no one's getting a man. Total Recall, Predator, Commando, action films. I love them. Favorite action hero? Arnold Schwarzenegger. Yes. Because Schwarzenegger is always asking questions.
What the hell is going on? What did I do wrong?
And he's always trying to explain his drama to other people that don't care.
Some men just tried to kill me. I think they were spies or something. Harry from work, he was the boss. Blood on my shirt, blood on my hands, blood on my knife. He tried to take my life. Get down!
Thank you. He's funny!
I like it.
I really like it.
I do like it, it's funny. Wait there a second, we've got something we've got to do.
Oh my God!
Together? Yeah!
That really moved me. I mean, Anton Deck, thank you so much, boy.
He's good. He's very good. He's good.
Congratulations.
Well done.
Yeah. There's no one out there that I can think of right now who's like that.
No, see you in the studio.
Well done.
Go and celebrate. Well done. Thanks, Rob.
Oh.
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Courtney Gilmore.
Courtney Gilmore.
Yeah, I'm a stand-up comic. I'm from Toronto.
So why Canada's Got Talent?
As a person with a disability, it's really nice to have visible representation, and I personally didn't really have a lot of that when I was coming up in stand-up, and it would be nice if I were that person for someone else. So, yeah.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
It is amazing. Have a good time, man.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, everyone, for having me. My name is Courtney. I am an arm amputee. I was born missing hands. No need to feel bad for me. I'm having a great no arms year. It's going really well, okay? Literally, no one is happier than me that we're done with handshakes, okay? Except maybe Howie. My friends love to ask me, Courtney, don't you ever just wish that you had hands? And I have to be honest with you, no, I don't. I don't wish I had hands. I mostly just wish you guys didn't have hands. That would be, that'd be great for me. This is a team effort. Body image is a very important thing to me. Self-esteem, you know, you got to be comfortable with who you are. I'm doing pretty well for myself, you know. Roll up the rim is a tough season, but that's fine. There are perks to being an amputee. For one example, I never have to get coffee for a bunch of people. Okay? I'm never the coffee run girl. You know, it's never me. 5 to 6 hot lattes in a tray, never seen it. Can I do it? Yeah. But who's gonna ask? Who looks worse? The guy who sends the girl with no hands out to get 8 large Americanos, or the barista who gives them to her? You know? Then I start asking for sleeves and it gets confusing.
That took me a second, but I got it.
I've had complete strangers come up to me and say, Courtney, you know, you're so brave. If I were you, I don't think I could do it. You know, if I were you, I think I would die. These are things that people say to me at a grocery store. Okay, I think I would die. I'm like, cool, I'm just trying to get mangoes, you know? And I say, yo, you know what? You wouldn't die. You would be absolutely fine. You would figure it out just like me. You would adapt to your surroundings. You would be good, you know? And then I see those same people spend 45 minutes at their self-checkout line trying to figure it out. And I'm like, you know what? You might die. You might die. I don't know. Thank you so much, everyone. Oh, good. Thank you. Good.
It is good to see you guys out, man. I was talking to the producers. They're like, hey, Emo, we're very excited to have you on the show. We just have a question. Have you booked your accommodation yet? I said, no, I haven't. I'm just looking for somewhere close by, cultured. As soon as I said cultured, they said, we got the perfect place. We said Blacktown.
Is that actually a town here?
It is a town.
I was like, ooh, that sounds nice. As soon as I got there, I was like, ooh, this ain't nice. So I moved areas. I thought this area was nice. It was called Penrith. Have you heard of this? Yeah, it's rough. But it is a massive upgrade from Blacktown, though, because I went from living around poor black people to now living around poor white people. And I love it. Every now and then, I've been getting, like, a random white guy come up and ask me for, like, loose change. And I give it to them. But I do it for the wrong reasons, though, ladies and gentlemen. I do it because I kind of feel like I'm rewriting history. Every time I give him change, I'm like, here you go, my man. Just don't spend it all on drugs. If only my mum could see me now. Oh, she's not dead. She's just not here. I was speaking to her on FaceTime this morning. She's like, hey, how's Penrith going? I'm like, ma, it's so beautiful. Very multicultural. You should see it. The white people ask me for money. And she was so proud. She's like, oh, my God, you're doing very well, my son. And then she calls my father into the FaceTime. She's like, Michael, come have a look at your son. He has become the king of the whites. I'm going to get buzzed off soon. can I get some water? Sorry, just one moment. Oh, my mouth is so dry.
Here we go.
Ooh. Oh, how unprofessional. I'm so sorry. Water is very hard for black people to find. There's been a lot of tension between white and black people over the last couple of years, but I think it's because we don't understand each other because of our differences in culture. And for us to ever move forward, I feel like we all have to do our part. Would you agree?
Yes.
Yes, I think white people, you need to stop assuming that all black people are out to steal things that are not theirs. And black people, man, we need to stop trying to steal back our stuff from white people, man. I think it's important if we're ever going to make a change, we have to start educating the younger generation. Like, for example, white people, you need to stop lying to your kids. This is my personal favorite lie. Make sure you finish off all your dinner, because somewhere in Africa, there's a child that would love to eat it. Nonsense. What you guys don't realize is African parents tell their kids a similar thing. Like, I remember my mom used to tell me, son, make sure you finish off all your dinner, because somewhere in Australia, there's a child eating food without seasoning, son. This is sick. Australia Got Talent. Who would have thought that the kid that survived two refugee camps would be on TV? Ladies and gentlemen, I've been Emo Majuk. Thank you.
Yeah!
Oh, very, very good.
Fantastic.
Thank you.
Fantastic. Yeah. This is yours.
What's your name?
My name is Samuel J. Camro. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing comedy for 10 years now.
Do you do it full-time?
Yeah, do it full-time.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No, I have Tourette syndrome, so I twitch a lot. I blink real fast. My head flops around. If you see that, it's kind of cute.
It is.
Thank you.
And what does this mean to you, coming to AGT now?
This means everything. I've worked my entire life for a moment like this. They don't come very often. I'm really grateful. I just had a baby girl, and this is a beautiful opportunity.
Wow. And your family's all supportive of this career?
Yes, since I started, they've been 100% behind me, so I'm very thankful.
All right. Well, you know what? It's scary enough doing whatever you do to hit that X, and I just want the best for you.
I really do. Thanks so much.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So like I said, I have Tourette's syndrome. It's why my head flops around. I blink real fast. It's weird. It always looks like I'm trying to tell you a secret. This twitch gets me in trouble. My roommate came home from work. I was like, dude, our neighbor died. He said, did you kill him? I was like, nah. Yo, this is a true story. When I was 10 years old, my parents sent me to Tourette's camp. Yeah, that's where the joke should end. It's a real place, and I didn't realize it till this moment, but I found out that when other people twitch, it makes me twitch more. So on the first day, they put us in a circle with 100 kids. Oh, no. The kid next to me did a shoulder roll. And my Tourette saw that and took that as a challenge. And I threw him a head flop. The girl next to him did a full body twitch, and everybody saw that, and all hell broke loose.
That is funny.
Kids were rolling on the ground. I was in the corner like, why'd they send us here? Our parents were on top of a hill like, oh, they're breakdancing. I'm Samuel J. Conroe, thank you.
Simon? I'll be serious today. I'll do as Simon says. I'll put this here and I introduce myself properly. My name is Viggo Venn. That means my mother is Norwegian and my dad is a diagram. I did stand up! I feel like we should get to know each other a bit closer.
Please. Yes!
Yeah? My name is Viggo.
My name is My name is
Viggo.
We remember
Viggo. Yeah. You want to try to?
No.
Okay.
Yes. My name is
My name is Viggo. You are Bruno, the new guy.
Yes. Oh, it's a girl.
The new guy.
Thank you for reminding me. Okay, I have to do all the work here. Are you ready?
Yes. I am ready again.
I start there, I come back to you.
Yes. Are you coming back? I promise.
My name is
Wow, so much attitude!
My name is Alicia! My name is...
Whoa!
My name is Alicia!
Wow, that's so good. Okay, Bruno,
coming back.
My name is...
My name is Bruno! My name is Bruno!
Someone was drinking before the show!
My name is Blue!
My name is... My name is...
My name is Blue!
My name is
Blue!
My name is... My name is...
My name is Blue!
My name is...
Oh, my God!
You want to try too? Okay.
My name is... My name is... My name is...
Hello, darling, it's Amanda.
My name is... My name is...
A little bit sexy!
My name is... My name is... My name is...
Hello, darling, it's Amanda.
My name is... My name is... My name is...
Hello, darling, it's Amanda.
Enthusiastic judge in the world!
My name is... My name is...
Cow.
My name is... My name is...
Cow.
My name is...
I could do this all night.
My name is... My name is...
Cow. Can I just keep... Can I do it to just
Yeah.
Can I do it just one?
No. No.
My name's Jack.
Jack.
Carol.
And how old are you?
14 years.
And tell me a little bit more about you.
I'm a professional gymnast.
All right, well, best of luck.
All right, cheers. Don't worry, I know what you're thinking. Harry Potter's had a nasty Quidditch accident. Do you know what I can't stand? Sorry, let me re-emphasise. Do you know what I can't stand? But look on the bright side. I've never had to queue at Disneyland. Now, I'm just going to throw a disclaimer out there. If I do get too energetic, please stop me. I want to keep my benefits. otherwise, how would I heat the jacuzzi? I'm joking. It's a pool. I was at the cinema seeing the new James Bond film the other day, and it got me thinking, you know, maybe I would have liked to have had a go, you know, being James Bond, but obviously I'm a bit inhibited. Ah, Mr. Bond, I've been expecting you. No lift. But this isn't the first Britain's Got Talent event I've been to. I was actually at the live tour in Manchester, funnily enough, 2 years ago. And the staff, they couldn't have been more helpful, moving people out the way, getting us to a seat. And then when we finally got there, the view was just fantastic. And we sat down and my sister, she tapped me on the shoulder, turned round, and I'll never forget this as long as I live. She said, "Jack, we are so lucky you're disabled. You cannot take her anywhere." Thank you very much. I've been Jack Carroll. Goodbye.
I'm going to have to go to David, first of all.
Jack, you are a comedy genius.
Thank you.
I wasn't as funny as you are 14 years old. I'm not even as funny now as you are at 14 years old. It was incredible. Every joke was a winner.
Thank you. Cheers. Thank you, David.
Jack, you made me laugh before the act even started, and...
I know, I've got a funny face.
No, you just... Jack... The thing that's great is nobody feels sorry for you. You're self-deprecating, you're hilarious, and I think you've got a huge future.
Well, I've got to tell you, Jack, you've got one of the most refreshing attitudes. You made fun, you know, of what you've gone through, and you made it funny, which is really, really difficult. You've just got an incredible personality. And I'm really happy that I met you.
Thank you.
Come on, four yeses.
Okay, David, yes or no?
It's a gigantic yes.
Alicia.
100% yes.
Amanda.
Yes for me, Jack.
Thank you.
Jack, you have. I think you know what's coming. Four yeses.
Oh my goodness, hello!
Hello, Alicia.
How are you?
I'm good, I'm really, really good.
I was not expecting to see you today. I've known Kojo for many, many years. Kojo, I'll let you tell my fellow judges about yourself.
I'm a stand-up comedian. Been doing comedy for 20 years. I've spent most of those 20 years encouraging young comedians and helping big name comedians and opening up for them. And my new fiance. We've got a little boy called Roman who's here as well. And she said that it was about time that I started thinking about myself and
my son.
Who makes you laugh?
Simon Cowell.
That's funny. Okay, well, look, Kojo, you know the show. 3 minutes, do your stuff.
Good luck, darling.
Thank you very much.
Come on, Coach!
Rooting for this. I want a good one.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I am a new dad for the first time. But all I want to do is be better than my dad, right? My dad had no patience, right? Me and my best friend, Michael Murphy, after school every day, we'd play football on the estate. I had the parent who would ruin that game by calling me inside for something I didn't think was necessary. All you would hear, because I've got African parents, right? My dad would shout like, "Kujo, come here." Now, Michael always had a confrontation with my dad. He was like, coach, what's going on, mate? The coach, you're a big man, you're 11. You go in there and you tell him that this enough's enough. Now, ladies and gentlemen, there was a little part of me that believed in Michael's spirit. But then I remembered, he don't live in my house. So I turned to my dad, I said, "Dad, what's up? Go to the store and get me Ribena." Ladies and gentlemen, this is all I said. "Dad!
can't you get it yourself?
It was 1 p.m, but it got dark real quick.
The pigeons weren't even flying anymore. They came down to warn me.
Ladies and gentlemen, I don't have any jokes, I got problems. Have you ever been to a bank, right? Because I'm not really happy with the customer services that we get at banks nowadays, right? Have you ever gone into a bank? You've seen 4 available windows, 4! But there's only 1 person working. Yes. Then you get the woman that works there who walks past the queue and says, don't worry, she won't be long. Go and help her! Why are you out here? You get to the cashier because it's your turn, right? They've now given the cashiers microphones, yeah? So everybody can hear your financial situation. I'm right here, I can hear you, right? And I'm already embarrassed about the amount that I need. So I was discreet, right? I was like, can I get £1.50, please? That weren't enough for her. She had to talk into the mic and get into my business. Sorry, sir, you need £1 to keep the account open. I'm like, why are you shouting? But I told you, I needed the rest of what was in my account. So I said to her, please, can I get that 50 pence? She said to me, how do you want that? I was like, in silence.
Nice.
I was so frustrated that I rushed out of the bank. I rushed out to be greeted by the most creative homeless person I have ever met. He rushed up to me and said, look, mate, I know you're in a rush, but can I please get 20 pence to get something to eat? Ladies and gentlemen, I looked at him and said, you know where to eat for 20 pence? I said, mate, I'm coming with you. I've got dinner for the both of us. When you're broke, right, and you ain't got no money, there's certain things that you can't enjoy, like a cab ride, right? You can't enjoy the black cab ride, you can't enjoy it, right? I went into a black cab recently, me and my mate, we jumped in. He was getting comfortable. Clearly, he's got more money than me. He was looking outside the window, talking to the driver. He fell asleep. Ladies and gentlemen, when you ain't got no money, you only look at one thing, the meter. The experience in a black cab is the most awful thing ever. They charge you before you even speak to the driver. You step in, 250. Hold on a minute. You sit down, £3. Hey! Let's discuss this. Ladies and gentlemen, it's got to a point where I don't even have a destination when I get into a black cab. When a driver says, where do you want to go? I say, take me to £5.
Very good.
My name's Kojo. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Joe, when you came on, I loved hearing about how you've grafted, how you've honed your act, how you've now got your little family. Yeah, and the act just got better and better, and then by the end you were like, yeah, I'd pay money to see this man. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
I'm so happy right now. I've always respected you. My respect level for you's just gone way up there, my friend. And let's see how far you can take it now.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Well, you know, when someone's really funny, there is nothing much to say other than you are brilliantly funny. Yeah. You made everyone laugh. You've kind of got all bases covered as a comedian. You're brilliantly likeable. You've got fantastic observational routines. I think you did yourself really proud today.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Kojo, what was quite amazing was I felt that you were nervous. Then I could see the audience reacting to you and you reacting to them. But I'm going to be honest with you, Kojo, I don't really like comedians on this show. but I love you. I really get it.
I have to tell you, I don't know what it is. You are so funny and so unpredictable. You just got the most amazing energy. This is the break you've been waiting for.
Thank you so much.
I could not be happy with you. Enjoy this.
I'm going to impersonate the Bee Gees. Take seconds to make up.
Go on, Jensen.
Oh my, whoa!
My baby moves at midnight. Right up to the door. My woman take me high, yeah.
My woman take me, whoa.
Baby, you should be dancing, yeah.
I have to confess, when I sing in a falsetto, I feel like I have lost my testicles.
Who's this now?
Better and better. Who's that?
Elvis.
I'm sorry for I don't look like Elvis. Because it's genetically impossible. Finally, I'm going to impersonate Godfather.
This'll be good.
Dear Judge, I'd like to thank you for helping me organize this meeting. We have associates and heads of different families from England, Scotland, Ireland. Thank you so much.
Hi.
Hello.
What's your name and your age?
My name is Aaron Belial, and I'm 28 years old.
Okay. And what is your talent?
Well, I can't dance. So I'm gonna do stand-up comedy.
Oh, wonderful! How long have you been doing this?
I did my first open mic about a year ago.
What got you into comedy?
Last winter, I ended up in Portugal. I ended up going to a comedy show there and making all the comics laugh, and they convinced me to try it.
Wow. So comedy generally is about timing. What is your process?
Please hold while the operator types his response. To do my comedy, I use a text-to-speech app. Interestingly enough, the silence while I type just builds tension during a set, and I think people enjoy watching me laugh at my own joke that I'm writing. You should also know that if you heckle me, my service dog is trained to go for the vocal cords.
Can I ask, do you have a day job?
I'm an engineer.
So, young man, the stage is yours. Best of luck.
Most of you look super confused right now, so let's talk about the elephant in the room. I know what you're all thinking. Who ordered Stephen Hawking off of Wish.com? He might be smarter than me, but I would beat him in a race. Unless the race is downhill, then I'm screwed. We also have different conditions. He had amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, and I am Canadian. Specifically, I'm half French, on my left side. I also have a brain muscle disability called cerebral palsy, but being French is way worse than a brain disability.
Wow.
I used to have the word handicapped in my social media bio, and then some random white lady messaged me telling me I need to change it to disabled.
Oh!
You can't say that word anymore. It is offensive to disabled people.
I don't think it's offensive. Last time I checked, I was pretty disabled.
Well, you don't get to decide what is offensive or not to disabled people.
Who the hell does then? Some two-legged, white woman on Facebook, who is probably commenting on her phone from a handicapped bathroom stall. Thank you for listening.
Funny, fearless, your dog is beautiful. It was just a great, great, great audition. This, I think, is going to change your life.
From the moment you started, you were funny, making fun of yourself, your energy. You're having such a good time up there. I hope that you are the one comedian that finally wins AGT.
I love how you found your way. I think you're very clever, you're cheeky, and you really were really funny. I mean, we were all laughing. It was fantastic.
I cannot believe you've only been doing this for 1 year, because you seem to have a grasp of timing and humor. You open up the conversation and normalize humanity and originality, and you're funny. I think, sir, you're not going to be doing engineering much longer. I think you're going to be full-time performing. That's my prediction. So I'm going to start off the voting with a yes.
And you're getting a big, fat yes from me.
Sophia?
Yes!
That makes it 4 yeses.
What's your name?
My name's Dante.
Oh, I love that name. How old are you, Dante?
13 years old.
Are you supposed to be at school this minute?
Yes, I am, but...
However...
Yeah,
do they know why?
Not really, no.
Oh, okay.
We'll keep it a secret.
And what is the reason that you decided to come on Britain's Got Talent?
So I was born with brittle bone disease. And I've came on Britain's Got Talent to show other people like myself that even if you've got some sort of disability or disadvantage, that you can go as far as your imagination wants to take you.
How would you spend the money if you won Britain's Got Talent?
I would buy my mum a giant house.
Aww. Is that who's in the wings, your mum?
Yes, I wouldn't go anywhere without her.
Well, the stage is yours. Good luck.
Thank you.
Amazing.
Why did I get it?
Me and Dante know each other.
Oh, do you?
We've met a few times. Because he said, could you write a book about a boy in a wheelchair? And I dedicated it to Dante.
Is that why you didn't insult him?
You write that song yourself?
Yes, in lockdown.
It really captured you, how cheeky you are, how special you are, and how much you do to inspire others too. So I loved it, Dante.
Thank you, that means so much.
Yeah, you're amazing. Very, very cheeky. Your laugh is really naughty as well, isn't it? What is there not to love about you? Well done, Dante. Thank you.
Comedy often has to make you think or make you go, oh God, are we allowed to say that? And that's when it's the best comedy. So that was a really funny song. Well done.
Thank you.
Yeah, you know, it was just a great audition. And if we put you through to the next round, can I help you write the lyric about someone on this panel?
We'll have to wait and see.
I always say a great audition is one you're going to remember, and I'm going to remember this. It was great. Can I be the first to say yes, please?
It's a yes from me, Dante.
I'm saying yes, Dante.
And it's a yes from me, so that's four yeses. Well done.
Where are you from?
I'm from South Norfolk.
What's your day job, Ben?
I do this act.
OK, I'm not going to ask what it is because we like surprises.
Lush.
Tell me why you've entered the show this
Lush.
Year.
Well, my two little boys, they say, come on, Daddy, you've got to be on Britain's Got Talent.
So you've got sons, you've got kids?
I've got two children.
OK, anything else?
Yeah, well, they did have a cat. Yeah.
Yeah. I won't go there. All right, Ben, good luck.
Thank you ever so much. Well, you see, I think my little stint now is all about me mishearing lyrics in music, see? I mean, it all started when I went to see The Lion King. Anybody see The Lion King? Yeah. Oh, I love The Lion King, but I must have misheard something, right? Because I thought the first song was about the Arsenal club football manager.
That's funny.
what I did then, right? I had a little think to myself. I thought, oh, maybe there's other songs, right, that you can hear that you think maybe they're singing something different, right? So I've amalgamated loads, and it's just for you. Hit it, Shirley!
Come on.
Good evening.
What's your name?
I'm Mickey.
Mickey?
Yeah.
Where are you from, darling?
I'm from the beautiful city of Leeds.
How old are you, Mickey?
I'm 36.
Do you have a day job or is this your full-time job?
I am a part-time primary school teacher.
Oh, lovely. Lovely.
Are you enjoying your food? Yeah, you've got to eat, you know.
The stage is yours, Mickey. Go for it.
Thank you very much. Cheers. This is called the absolutely amazing song.
Yes.
About travelling round Europe.
Oh.
That rhymes.
I like him.
I'm off to Paris in a Yaris. This next song. I know this is supposed to be a comedy routine, but I've suffered loss recently.
Ah, no.
So I just want to get this off my chest. Joe, I'll play the song because I'd get a bit emotional talking about it. I can't believe I've lost you. I can't believe you've gone. I need you to know that you did nothing wrong. First time I saw you, just hanging there. The checkout lady said, do you want to buy one of these? And I said, all right, go on then, yeah. You were my bag for life.
Is what?
My bag for life.
What?
My bag for life. For life.
We could have saved the world together.
You can either buy a teeth carrier bag or a bag for life, which is better quality and a bit more expensive.
Yes, I paid the price. You cost almost 10 pence and I only used you twice.
The other bags I use compared to you are slack. I always feel that the handle strap is gonna. Has it happened to you a lot as well? Oh, back for life.
It was a fairy tale of love. Thank you.
This is the story about love. When a guy meets a girl in a bar. He sees the girl. He looks at her. And all he wants to say is a great big...
Hello. Is it me you're looking
looked lovely. The dress that night she was wearing was...
gold!
She wasn't looking at him, so he showed her his best dance moves.
Shuffling. She comes over, she says to go, hey, you look thirsty. You want a drink? What you want?
Tequila.
What?
Tequila.
Why?
It makes me happy.
Fair enough. The girl looks at the guy and says, I'm sorry, I've got to go to the toilet. Don't go, he says. Please don't go.
Please don't go.
Suddenly, the girl comes back.
I'm so excited. I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it.
The girl laughs at the guy and says, hey, wanna come back to my place for a coffee? The guy says, hey.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night.
So the guy got with the girl, and now they've been together for 45 years.
If I could turn back time.
And that is the fairy tale of love.
Thank you for watching.
Oh my goodness, you guys, I'm so excited to be here. This is my first time doing stand-up commando. My kids would be mortified. Our daughter graduated from Dalhousie University with a degree in gender and women's studies. It's okay, we also laugh. And while she was away, and she and her young friends invented this new concept that they call feminism. But you know what's fun about having a 24-year-old new feminist come home for the summer? Nothing. Our son, thankfully, that one was as deep as a cereal bowl. He's a mechanic now, so he fixed the brakes on our car just recently. It's finally paid off to have had him. Those of you with toddlers, hang in there. Thank you.
I agree, this is a big, bold move to be here tonight. What made you want to do this?
Well, my husband is ill. He just recently got diagnosed with dementia.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah, so?
Where is he?
I don't know. He should be here. Does anybody know
right
where
there,
he is?
He's right there. He's right there.
There he is. That's my guy. We needed to make hay while the sun shines. And so we're working hard to do lots of fun things that we've always wanted to do.